Okay, this is how I make my banding for my soaps. Using a Canva website, which is www.canva.com, I'll go on create a design. From there, I will scroll down to documents and I will do A4 document. From here, this is the side panel. So you have templates, photos, elements, text, background, uploads, folders, and more. I'm going to click on elements. And then you then have a choice. Recently used, grids, charts, frames, shapes, and it scrolls down to many more. I'm going to go click all on the grid. And then I'm going to look for the lengthways grids like this. But I use 7. You don't have to. You can do 6, 5, 4. Depends on the size of your layout. I'll do it with a 6 just to show you. Though there is a 7th one, but it takes lots of searching. In between, you can see these little white spaces. Well, actually, that's your background. Your spacing is each of these. So for my background, I'm going to go over to the thing on the back, click on background. Solid colour. And click the line, which is C9E265. Now my background has gone green. One thing I will do on my spacing, wrong bit, that's my background, is I'll turn my spacings all white. To get that, I actually clicked on spacing here. Then I'll click on the word spacing and my grid spacing, and I will change the size of that. As you can see, it can go bigger, smaller. I'm going to set that about 30. And these I will cut. When I cut my labels, I will have green banding on the top. And I will now go to my text. And I will add the subheading. I will move this into place. We'll choose an automatic face type. On this side, you have a full list of all the different face types they've got. They've been through in the search bar. I'm going to type in petite, and that will bring up the petite formal script, which is what I want. And there, that automatically changes my font to what the type I want. This button changes your size. So I've changed that to 28 at the moment, but I actually need that one at 14. And then I'm going to zoom in to make it a bit bigger for me to see it all. Okay. I'm now going to add more text and do the subheading one. This I want at a size 12, and once again I want to change it to the petite formal script. Let me see it's centered. I'll change it in a moment. Let's get this in. I just need to extend. It all fits in. And the name of my soap, I want to take that one up to 14. Then I want to add some new text. So I want to change the whole sizing to 12. And once again, change the writing. That now I need it so it's a bit smaller because this is taking a lot of my space up. So what I'm going to do now, so I'm going to highlight my three lots of text, and I'm going to click group. This makes it one big group now. So I can change the size of them. Is it ungroup at the moment? Okay. Now, rather than typing it, I will admit I'm going to copy it from a previous one I have done. One I made earlier. I've got messages to the information. Right, copy that way. In here, I'm going to add my body of text. Across a bit. Add the first word that I didn't manage to highlight. And then I'm going to right click and paste. And obviously I'm going to change the size of this. I'm going to take it down to 6. And then using this bit here, I'm going to rotate to 90 degrees. Okay. Then on the other side, this just shows you my example. I will have my ingredients. Now at the moment, so I'm going to do the right click, highlighting and copying and pasting. And I do this in a different writing for my ingredients and my instructions. Go back there. So, okay, once you get the four pointed arrows, you can start moving it. Paste. Okay, get rid of the A. Change the sizing. Okay, I need to go to the end of the word. Six. These white centre ones. So the word ingredients is rather large, so I'm going to change that and all. Now, you can use corner to move it slightly, and that's how I managed to get 7. Now obviously this ingredient's very different soap, because my base soap's all the same. All I will need to change is this that's highlighted. Now I will admit I need to get my essential oil inky names up first and work out what their allergens are going to be, so I can't do that at the moment. What I'm going to do, if I delete that, okay, this I'm going to move slightly this way because I also have a logo. So now I've got all my text in, I can start playing around with my logo. So I will click on upload, and this gives me the images I've uploaded. Now obviously you need to put in how long your product lasts. I've already uploaded mine, but if you're not uploaded, you click upload an image. And that will take you to your desktop and all your images, pictures, so you choose whatever one you're after. Although I'm not, so although I've got it uploaded, I'm going to click on this image here and open. So you'll see it's that one. I'm just re-uploading it. And then from there, I'm going to go back to my elements. I'm going to get rid of the grid. And this is where I'll go for the shapes or the frames. So I'll click the frame. Now I personally need to use a circle, so you can bring it up a bit, and then you resize it to the size that you require. Now if you go to uploads and find your image, mine's saying this, actually I don't want that one. I want my 6 month pop jar. And I want to take it so it just goes into that frame. And it's been a pain. I need to make it a bit smaller so I can see what I'm working. There. That's my pot jar. Now in. So you want to keep your frame with that initial image on so you know where you're aiming your image, because if you turn it white you won't be able to find it. Now my other one is my logo, so once again I'm going to elements and I'm not looking for frames again. I just want a plain rectangle frame. I think to make this easier, I'll keep this large for now so you can see it in big scale. Hopefully this will work. I'm going to put my logo into the frame. Now the logo's in the frame, I can start shrinking my logo in its frame already. Maybe I should have done this with a circle one. Okay, and that shows my first one. So I want to group all that. So now that's all my information grouped. I want to click copy. And then I want to bring the copy down. And try and keep that guideline. Just come down a little more. Okay. And I'll click off it. Click on. Copy. And bring down. And to make sure it's all lined up to that centre line. Now I know my writing's slightly off, but that's because where the logo and everything goes for the bending of my soap. And then I'll carry on doing that until I have something which looks like this. And then you just click on the download button, because it, all right, let me show you. And here is where you give it its name at the top. So for me, it will be Eternity. Thinking. Latte. Soap. File. Save. Now on the arrow, now click download. You do have a file type choice, but I do stick to the PDF print suggested, and then you click download. I'll then open it. I remember I didn't do the full thing because there's only my example. And then I would click save as, choose the folder where I want to save it. Now mine, I'm actually keeping it in my PIP file, my product information file. And you can see all the others that I've done, and then obviously click save, which I'm not going to because it's not completable. The other thing I do if I want to print it is I click print and choose how that shows the look of it, and then choose how many copies I want, and then I'll print it off. Once that's done, I will use my guillotine slicer and I will start slicing them. So I'll have printed off on an A4 piece of paper. I'll then just cut and guillotine. So I have the sizes I want. Now some of these, the top and the bottom one, don't always work if you're trying to banding on top and bottom, which is a shame. I can make use of them, but I've yet to figure out how to get the banding on the top and the bottom. Okay, thank you.